Hey guys, what's going on? So just a quick little PSA to notify everyone watching this here. King's Raid is having a 1 year anniversary pre-register event. Lots of rewards are available. We're going to quickly go through how it works and see what's going on with it. So they say they have prepared an event page for pre-register to celebrate their 1 year anniversary. They have lots of rewards and events ready to be shown, so it would be in your best interest to participate in the awesome pre-register. So depending on which language you speak, you can go to the English, Spanish, Russian, etc. I'm going to open that in a new tab so you can see where that brings you. So here's the pre-register page. We'll go through this in a bit, but first we're going back to the page and read on. So the time you have to participate is until February 11th, so there's not a huge rush, but you may as well do it before you forget. And just for pre-registering, you'll get 700 fragments, 3 10 plus 1s, and 10 million gold. That's the first event. The second event is sharing the 1 year anniversary event page on Facebook. And the more people that do that, the more and better rewards we get, starting with 1,000 rubies, going to a 10 plus 1, a T1 hero ticket, and if 200,000 people pre-register, there will be a unique weapon ticket. And there's also a third event where they'll have three types of gifts awaiting for you. So I guess this doesn't have anything to do with pre-register. Just make sure to log on the 12th of February, or that's when it starts. And that's pretty much it. So we're gonna go back to the pre-register phase. So it's pretty easy. You just choose your server. I'm in Europe. Gonna go ahead and put my nickname in and hit pre-register. And then they say it's done, and they ask to please Facebook share. And that's pretty much all you have to do, and then we can see what's going on with the 1 year anniversary event. Alright, so I was a little overwhelmed with what's going on here, but I think I understand it. So there's going to be 5 days of rewards for their 1 year anniversary, and you can choose one of three. So there's the Kings section, the Raid section, and the Vespa section. It's pretty damn crazy. Like, the rewards here are freaking monstrous, if I understand everything right. I mean, unless this is a typo, over here in day 3 on Raid, we can see 10 stones of infinity, 80 of each essence, 300 of each mysterious skill book, and 5 heroic runes. Well, let's go ahead and start with day 1. On day 1, you can choose to have a unique weapon ticket, a T1 hero ticket, 100 deluxe potions, and 200 XP potions extra large, or a unique weapon ticket, 30 million gold, and 30 stamina potions. So let's compare those two. Well, they both come with a unique weapon. This one has a T1 hero ticket, but this one has 30 million gold. So I think Kings is actually the better of those, and definitely better than the Vespa option as well, where you just get the magic powder in exchange for the T1 hero ticket. I guess. I must be misunderstanding something, because these rewards are way too crazy. It doesn't mean like one out of the four, but no, that couldn't be. Otherwise, why would they? That's so weird. And then let's look at day 2, where Kings is offering 500 of each fragment. What the hell? 30 stamina potions, another T1 hero ticket. No, this is weird. And 10 million gold. Over on day 2, we have a normal 3-star hero ticket up to Scarlet. Oh, so that's kind of a better one. Because this T1 hero ticket on day 2, it's just up to heroes who appear at the inn, but it is T1. So this would be better for newer players, and the 3-star would be better for veteran players, in my opinion, because they can get the new heroes. That also comes with 250 of each type of fragment, a 7-day gold boost, and a 7-day EXP boost. But this one apparently comes with 3,500 fragments, 30 stamina potions. I would have to again go with Kings in this case because of that many fragments and the T1 hero ticket. You could actually, if you don't have any heroes you want and don't plan on getting, you could actually change that into a Stone of Infinity and a lot more fragments. I think around 1,000 extra fragments as well, or maybe it's even more than that. So I would have to go with Kings in that case as well. We can check out Vespa. That's kind of a hard one as well. 3 each ancient enchant scrolls. The ancient ones are the best ones, I believe, or there might be legendaries as well. But 3 stones of infinity, that's also something to consider. But when you think about it, 500 of each fragments is equivalent to 3.5 stones of infinity, so 3.5. And then you get the stamina potions, the T1 hero ticket. So again, I think I have to go with Kings on this one. Even though the ancient enchant scrolls are quite tempting because of how rare they are. Day 3 doesn't actually seem all that interesting, except for maybe newer players. T6 Legendary Gear, no one at mid to end game needs that. T6 Enhancement Crystal, well, it's a super Enhancement Crystal, so I'm not sure if it's like just maxes out whatever it goes into it, who knows. And some skill books. So Day 3 isn't very interesting on King's side, for me at least. Ten Stones of, yeah, this is the one with 10 Stones of Infinity over on Raid, and 80 of each essence, so there's no question about going for this one. That just doesn't seem real, that doesn't seem right. There must be some kind of, like, typo there, maybe an extra 1 or a 0. Well, hopefully not an extra 1, because that would make 0. But. And over on Vespa, we have a random unique weapon ticket. I would still have to go for the 10 Infinity Stones, definitely. I mean, and 80 of each essence, that's just insane. So checking out Day 4, we have another 3 Stones of Infinity over on Kings, a 3 loot boosters, and a costume ticket up to idle costumes. Over on Raid, we have another costume ticket up to idle costumes, 10 loot boosters, 100 deluxe potions, and 250 extra large potions. Well, 10 loot boosters is freaking a lot. I'm thinking about going for that. And then on Day 4 over here, we have another random unique weapon and a rune preserve. Well, it's kind of tough. Probably I would go for the 10 loot boosters, though. Or the 3 more Stones of Infinity. I mean, what the hell? 10? 10 Stones of Infinity? I still can't get over that if that's actually a gettable reward. Anyhow. Yeah, Day 4 is a pretty hard choice. I mean, you still get 3 loot boosters here and 3 Stones of Infinity, but 10 loot boosters can take you far. I still have some from a while ago, so I can't use them that often, but I would have like a good supply of loot boosters for a while. Just those 3 Stones of Infinity, it's hard. And then on Day 4, I probably wouldn't bother. I don't really care about the rune preserve ticket and the random unique weapon. You know, it's random. If it was a selector, of course, there'd be no question, but random probably signifies it's not going to be one you really want. And then finally, taking a look at Day 5, we have a random unique weapon, 1,000 rubies, 2 7-day EXP boost, and 2 7-day gold boosts. On Raid, we have T6 Super Enhancement Crystal, Magic Powder, Costume Ticket. Okay, there's literally no comparison there at all. I mean, 1,000 rubies, 4 7-day boosts total, and a random unique weapon. So that's what kind of makes me think there's something off with my thinking here, because there's no way anyone in their right mind would ever choose Raid's Day 5 over King's Day 5. And then over on Vespa, we have 15 Reforged tickets, which are quite nice as well. Still don't think it's worth more than 2 week-long boosters and 1,000 rubies. Well, the 1,000 rubies, yeah. If you're the type to reforge, you're probably saving about 3,000 in reforging, because usually you'll reforge once for 100 rubies and then spend a reforge ticket when it would cost 200. So essentially, that's like 3,000 rubies there. And then finally, we have the King's Raid 1-year anniversary Facebook share event. And so yes, please share this on Facebook however you can. I'm gonna do it. Congrats on your first year, Vespa. All right, so I assume that is done. So what makes me think we can only have one of those three is something they said in their patch note. It says you can collect one of the three once you log in on the 12th of February. The special attendance event is for the 1-year anniversary, may have some changes. So there could be some misunderstandings here, but that's what it seems like to me. But it could also mean you get to choose like one side to be with, either Kings or Raid or Vespa, and then you get those 5 days of rewards. And if that were to be the case, I would probably go with Raid, because still of the 10 Stones of Infinity. I mean, there are some other really good things in there as well, but this by far is the biggest thing in my opinion, unless there's some weird like typo there, or they didn't mean it to be that high. There's also the 10 loot boosters. So I think if you have to choose one and stick with it for the 5 days, Raid gets my vote. There are some really good things in Kings as well, just I would never be able to pass up 10 Stones of Infinity. Also 80 of each essence and 250 of each fragment. Apparently it says 250 each. So make sure to do this. I think regardless if you do it or not, you'll get the 1-year anniversary event. Since it's just the 1-year anniversary, I don't think you have to pre-register or anything, but you won't get any of the Facebook rewards, even if you don't share it, but pre-register. pre-register, I think you're still eligible for the rewards, but you have to at least pre-register because these will be guaranteed at least, regardless. And seven types of each fragments, that's already way more worth than the minute or two it takes to pre-register. It doesn't even take a minute. You throw your server up, you put in your nickname, you hit pre-register, it's done. 7,500 rubies worth of summons, 10 million gold. There's really no reason you shouldn't do this. And sharing to Facebook, if you have a Facebook account, only takes a few seconds as well. So go for it. All in all, it's really exciting. The rewards here are freaking crazy good. Again, I'm not sure how it works yet. If we can really only choose one of three, if we can choose them per day, then you heard my recommendations beforehand or what I'm going to choose if it is like that. If you can only choose one, like, faction or whatever to go with for the entire 5 days, then raid is my choice. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This is kind of long for a PSA, but I wasn't anticipating because I hadn't really checked out before. I wanted to save like my reactions and stuff for actually recording, so I wasn't anticipating it to have all of this in it. I was just thinking it's like a pre-register thing, maybe a few rewards here and there, but this is crazy stuff. So make sure to check it out. Don't miss this. Make sure to leave a comment down below telling me what you think about it. Leaving a like would also be greatly appreciated if you did happen to enjoy. Thanks, as always, for watching, and until next time.